Hello, welcome to another edition of the Mr. Lewis Mini Lecture. I am Chad Lewis, pastor, teacher, and author, and today's topic is McChurch. McChurch is the phrase I use to describe what I call the McDonaldization of Christianity. That is to say, the tendency, particularly of American Protestant evangelicals, to transform their churches into businesses. Not a place where people are bound together into relationships over the long term through a shared spiritual life, but an institution where they engage in finite transactions through the buying and selling of religious goods and services. Now, how did all of this come about? Well, I don't know that I can fully answer that question. A few things I will say is that when Christianity was still in vogue in America, a large number of American evangelical Protestant churches tried to increase their numbers and also improve their institutions by adopting a corporate model, a model like that of a corporate business. And the immediate results of this were positive. Large numbers of people did come into their churches, and their institutions became more professional and profitable. However, as the country has ceased to be de facto Christian, the results of this shift have revealed that something of the original spirit of Christianity has been lost in the meantime, and now the chickens have come home to roost. An unfortunate result of the McChurch movement is that the church is increasingly interested in maintaining itself as an institution and less concerned about the people who go into that institution. If they don't like a pastor, they fire them. If people don't fit into the system of what they're doing, they get rid of those people and bring in others. Meanwhile, as they're maintaining the building, the programs, the air conditioning, and the budget, people come and go, but they aren't really nourished intellectually, morally, or spiritually. And the people themselves contribute to this by not asking for anything more from a church than a little entertainment, a little social activities, and some social programs to help them run their families. Pastors, in their part, are almost complete sellouts to the trend of the McChurch movement, or if they do try to draw a line in the sand, they draw it in the wrong place. They dig down and become firm about their principles, forgetting that a church is, after all, a community of people. So that's the problem. What's the solution? Well, broadly speaking, to remember that a church is a family of people, not an institution to maintain. And in fact, it is part of our faith that people are what is eternal, not institutions. So if all of our effort is directed toward maintaining the institutions while we're ready to let people come and go as we please, we've somehow missed the point. A lot of practical advice could be given here, but two things worth mentioning. First of all, as a family, a church ought to look like the people that make it up. Pastors should not be so idealistic to make their church into something special that they outsource their music and their teaching and their programs to other hired paid professionals in order to make the church look slick. Church needs to look like the people that make it up. As for the people, they need to show up at church. Hopefully not more than is reasonable, but they need to show up at church, they need to offer their gifts, and they need to be content with the limits of the family to which they have bound themselves. Every family has its limits. So, are you part of a McChurch movement? Here's six signs that can alert you. First, if your church seems to care more about the institution than the people, you might be part of a McChurch movement. If the church seems to hire and fire its leaders as though they are simply paid professionals, you might be part of a McChurch movement. If the church seems less interested in taking care of the people who have maintained and sustained it for years past and is more interested in running out after others, you might be part of a McChurch movement. If the church is less interested in activities which are not revenue producing, everything that it does produces money somehow. If it's not contributing to your intellect, if it's not contributing to charitable things like care for poor or orphans or widows or visitation of the sick or the lonely, you might be part of a McChurch institution. And what is the atmosphere, or to say the motive, for all that they do? If the church is guided by fear of what might happen to it and does not have the peace or the joy which are the hallmarks of the true Christian life, you could be part of a McChurch movement. If you have any of these six attributes, you might be part of McChurch. Make sure that wherever you go, it's a place where you are feeling that you're growing intellectually, your spiritual sensitivity is growing, and as well as your moral insight and activity. Church is a place for growth, the binding together of human relationships over the long term. Avoid McChurch.